The electronic configuration of an element determines its physical and chemical behavior. This simple but powerful concept is at the center of all chemistry. It explains why chlorine is a gas, while potassium, only two atomic units away in the periodic table, is a metal. It explains why fluorine readily becomes a negative ion, while sodium just as readily becomes a positive ion. In this tutorial, we'll examine three specific properties of atoms as a function of their electronic configuration. First, we'll look at atom size, then at ionization energy, that is, the amount of energy needed to remove the outermost electron. Lastly, we'll look at electron affinity, the tendency for an atom to attract an additional electron. The chemical properties that we commonly associate with the elements follow from these physical properties. For example, the metallic nature of an element is a direct consequence of that element's tendency to lose electrons. We'll also look at acid-base behavior of various oxides, as well as the nature of ionic forms of the elements. The periodic table catalogs how physical and chemical properties vary from element to element in a periodic pattern. That is, trends are observed over a set of elements that suddenly, though predictably, start over. It might help to consider another periodic table you're intimately familiar with, the periodic table of the days, otherwise known as a calendar. Each day of the week changes in a predictable way from the previous day. Mondays are the first work day. Saturdays and Sundays are weekends. Every 7 days, the pattern starts over. The periodic table of the elements is like a calendar. Properties vary across a row, while elements in the same column share many properties. The periodic table organizes the elements so as to emphasize these periodic trends. Understanding the basis of these periodicities is essential to a practical application of chemistry.